back with yet another amazing recipe. I am so excited yet another day because today at the Young's house, Gina Young is going to share with you all how easy it is to make delicious lemon pepper wings. These lemon pepper wings right here, I just have to say it, they are so delicious. So easy to make, doesn't require a lot of ingredients, and you know, make it Gina Young style, they are gonna be so tasty. Y'all never had my lemon pepper wings before. Better make you some. Here are the lovely ingredients you're gonna need. You will need some fresh wings, okay? And my wings are whole. I have washed them off with lemon juice, salt and cold water, and then we've pat them dry. Feel free to get the kind of wings that are already chopped up. Excuse me. You're gonna also need some flour. So you can make this without flour, and later on during this video, I'll talk about if you decide that you don't wanna use flour. Okay, so any kind of flour you wanna use. You got all-purpose flour, like what I'm using. You can use self-rising or rice flour. You know, it'll all do the trick. You're gonna need some butter. So I got a stick of butter here. This is Kerrygold salted butter. You can use unsalted. You're gonna need some lemon. This would never be able to be called lemon pepper wings if we didn't put some fresh lemon juice and also some fresh lemon zest. We're gonna be using a little tiny bit of garlic powder. You will need some lemon pepper seasoning, some black pepper and salt, and some parsley flakes so we can make it nice and beautiful. And here in my pan, I have a little tiny bit of oil. We're not deep frying these, so my oil is about this deep here. Listen here, make sure your hands are impeccably clean. Let's get started with this really quick and simple, yet so tasty recipe. I couldn't be more excited to share with you all how easy it is to make something different. You know, because a lot of people, they ask me for recipes like, Gina, I want chicken wings, right? This is the messages that I get. I want chicken wings, but I want something different. I want it to be packed with flavor, you know? And that's what I'm gonna do today. I'm gonna pack these wings with so much flavor, you're gonna feel like you're eating something different, even though you may have had chicken yesterday. This recipe is so stinking easy. And like I said earlier, it doesn't require a lot of ingredients. It's just a few steps to cook it. You don't have to be slaving over the stove, you know, to make it. And dinner's gonna be on the table in no time. That's what I love about this recipe. So if you can see that I've cut my wings into two sections, and we have the drum here, and we have the flat piece that I love. There's something about that big drum piece, I'm not a fan of it, but I love the flat part. Now, sometimes you may have to give your knife a little whack, just like so, to cut your wing ding, and if you do, hey, that's fine. You know, take your time. Don't rush when you're cooking, okay? That's one of the worst things that you could do, is rush through it. Like, have patience. Take your time. If you need help, ask one of the guys in the house to help you out a little bit. Okay, so look at this. But I do want to talk about the wing tips. The wing tips, it's very important that you don't throw them away. Guess what? Here's what I like to do. I like to put the wing tips into a freezer bag, and then I like to date it, throw it into the freezer. And anytime you want to make like a nice chicken broth, or someone's sick, make up a nice chicken broth using all of these wing tips that you've saved and that you've frozen, okay? So now I'm gonna continue to chop up these just like so. And when I come back, we're gonna get started seasoning our wing dings just like so. So now, what I wanna talk about is if you decide that you don't wanna use flour. A lot of people may say, is it gonna taste this good? Absolutely, it's gonna taste good. But today, I figure I want a little bit of crunch, a little bit more crunch, you know, than it would be without the flour, okay? So if you use the flour, you're gonna get a little bit more crunch, a little bit more crispiness, and that's what we're gonna do today. If you don't use it, you'll still get crunch, you'll still get crispy, but not as crispy, okay? So now, I'm gonna go ahead and season with a little bit of garlic powder, just like so, in this manner, okay? We're gonna use some black pepper. All right, and then we're gonna go in with some salt. I hope that you all are having an amazing day today. Let me know in the comment section below, have you ever tried lemon pepper wings? If you haven't, you're in for a treat, because it's easy, It's delicious and it's so much fun to make. Okay, so I'm just gonna turn it over just like so, season the other side. Now, if you're the person that you decided that you didn't want to use the flour, I don't suggest using the garlic powder. Guess why? Well, the reason is because the garlic powder will burn because it's a powder form. It's different from the salt in the black pepper, okay? So what you could do is you could turn around and cook your wings, and then when they're done, you can sprinkle a little bit of garlic powder on them then. Okay, so I'm seasoning the other side. If I haven't said, I hope y'all are having a great day today, I do. I hope y'all are having an amazing day and a great week. Okay, so now we're getting some garlic powder on, some black pepper, and I want for my wings to set for at least 20 minutes to come up to room temperature. And the purpose for doing that is I do it with all of my meats. I let my meat come up to room temperature. That way when it hits that hot oil, it's already nice and relaxed. Because if you take it out of the refrigerator, it's freezing cold, and you put it into the oil, it's gonna seize up and it's gonna cook up dry every time. But you let it kind of hang out on the counter, come up to room temperature, and it also gives time for that spices to seep down into that beautiful protein as well. So what we're gonna do is we want to go ahead and dredge the wings, and then we let them set for about 20 minutes, okay? Flour. A lot of times you may see me use like a flour and cornstarch, half and half. If you wanted to do that, absolutely you could, okay? But today this is just flour. Okay, now we're gonna let this set for 20 minutes, and when I come back, this goes into the hot oil. So now we're gonna go ahead and put our wings into our oil. You wanna make sure that your oil is nice and hot, and I like to tell people my little trick. So how can you make sure that your oil is nice and hot? Well, listen here. You can take a little tiny bit of flour in your hands, and you do like this. You sprinkle it into the oil, and if that flour sizzles right away as soon as it hits the oil, your oil's nice and hot. But let's just say you do this and you do your flour, you get your flour in there, but you see a ball of flour go straight to the bottom, your oil's not hot enough. You never wanna cook your chicken in oil that's not hot enough. So let's check it. Come on in, let's see what happens. It should be sizzling, look at that. I'm so happy with that. That's what's supposed to happen. So now we're gonna give it a nice little shake before it goes into the oil. Yes, our oil is nice and hot. It should be bubbling and sizzling. I don't know if y'all can see and hear that, but that's what it should be doing right now. We're gonna get all our wings into the oil. And when I come back, I'm gonna show you all how to make this really easy, delicious lemon pepper sauce that we're gonna coat these wings in. So our wings are cooking. I've disinfected my cutting board, and now what we want to do is make this beautiful sauce that is irresistible. And listen here, I do want to add an ingredient. I gotta add me some chicken powder. Chicken powder is a chicken bouillon seasoning, and it comes in a powder form. Okay, so that's what it looks like, and it has flavor that's out of sight. It's really gonna take these wings up a notch. Now, you may be the person to say, I'm not gonna use the chicken powder, Gina. Well, you don't have to. You can use it or you don't have to use it. Either way, if you use it or if you don't, it's gonna be delicious. But if you use it, it's gonna be even more better. I know. So now we're cutting the lemon just like so. And I wanna use some of the lemon juice, okay? So I'm gonna get some of this lemon juice right into a bowl. And I only need, let's just say, this is a large lemon. This is a large lemon. If you have a large lemon, just use a half of a lemon, okay? There are some seeds in there that I'll go back in and I'll get those seeds out, okay? So we got some beautiful lemon juice here that's gonna go into our gorgeous lemon pepper sauce, okay? I'm gonna fish that seed out and I'll be right back. I'm gonna grab some lemon zest. And anytime you're zesting something, you don't want to get that white pith part. That part right there has a really funky taste. But the yellow part has a really beautiful, subtle taste, a bright taste like that the world loves. Okay, and you're going to love it too. Look at that. Pretty simple, right? Let's get all of the zest off of a half a lemon, just like so. And we're going to add it to our lemon juice. Be right back. Turn some of our wings over. I can smell that they got a beautiful golden brown color. And they do. That is so beautiful. And that's what we're looking for. We're looking for our wings to get gorgeous and golden brown on all sides of the wing, okay? Just like so. And we'll check in on this one over here. Come on over. That one's not golden brown yet, but we'll flip it around. And when they get beautiful golden brown, we'll come back and check in on them. Now it's time to make our beautiful lemon pepper sauce. There's the zest. Get that zest in with the lemon juice. Okay? Get all that goodness out, right? And just mix the two together. And then we can set it aside for the time being. Now let's work our way over here. We're gonna put one stick of butter right into our little pan that we have here. Heat your pan up, you know, like on a low heat. We want the butter to get hot and melty. We are then gonna use some parsley flakes just to make it nice and beautiful, okay? And we're gonna use some salt, but guess what? I'm not gonna use a whole lot, you're gonna see. Little tiny bit, that's it. Because I am gonna use chicken powder, and I'm using about that much. That right there, it's gonna really season these wings, trust me. And now we're gonna go in with a nice amount of the lemon pepper seasoning, okay? Just like so, you need that seasoning. We want it to taste like lemon pepper, right? Yes, we do. And now we're gonna go in with garlic powder, but we're not gonna use too much, okay? That's it. A little bit more pepper, because you need it. And then guess what? You stir it around. And this is your lemon pepper sauce that we are going to toss our beautiful wings in. And I tell you what, if you were to taste this like right now, which you don't want to do because this is like hot lava, when it cools down, give it a taste and you're going to say, oh my, it is so delicious. So now, when we come back, we'll check in on our wings. There's a lot of them that need to be flipped over. And then when the wings are done, we toss them in this gorgeous sauce. I don't want to get ahead of myself. I don't want to forget that little tiny bit of lemon juice with the lemon zest, it goes in as well. Get all that goodness out. Mix it up, turn the sauce off. Let's turn these babies over. They should be golden brown. Oh yes, I'm very happy with the color. And we're going to continue to cook these chicken pieces until they are well, fully cooked. Just like so. Oh yeah. So now, while our wings cook up, I do want to let you know that you might be able to see behind me where I put a little bit of foil on top of our wings. And by covering your wings, it's going to make sure that the inside of your wings, they are done for sure. You know, you don't want to serve raw wings, right? So you can cover them sometimes and then you're going to be assured that your wings are going to be fully cooked, nice, beautiful, and golden brown on the outside. Let's make a garnish. Okay, so here's what I'm gonna do. I'm doing a number like this, but you'll see. I'm doing like that, like this, like that, like this, all the way around, okay? Until I get a beautiful cut lemon that I can present on my platter. That's just gonna make everybody say, ooh, that's cute, you know? I like to wow my family and my loved ones with beautiful stuff. I really do. I like for everything that I cook to look beautiful. You know, even if it's a garnish, I want it to look nice and beautiful. Let's see, am I at the end? We're almost there. Okay, so let's open this baby. Look at that, voila. And then guess what we do after that? It's gorgeous, right? And it's so much fun. Take a little bit of parsley. You really want to fancy them out. I know you're trying to fancy somebody. All right, look at that. Put that parsley in there. Voila, this is gonna set on the side of the wings. It's gonna be beautiful. Let's just talk about the beautiful color that we're starting to achieve on these gorgeous wings. They got a little bit while to go, but we got patience. Have patience in the kitchen. So now some of our wings are done and there's some pieces that are not done. So what I've done was I've taken the wings that are done out and I've set them on a platter, and the other wings that are not ready, we still have them cooking and they're covered with foil. Okay, so I figured I'm gonna go ahead and make a big old jug of Kool-Aid. Like, who doesn't love Kool-Aid? Kool-Aid is perfect to go with these wings. We're making a tropical punch today. I'm just gonna whip this up just like so. I'm gonna give it a nice stir. I'm so excited about today because these wings, me and my family, we go nuts over this recipe. And you will too. As you can see, our wings are done. They're beautifully golden brown. Take a look at that. Now, I have to be honest, there was one of them that got a little dark in the beginning. I got rid of that one. It was a little too dark for me. Okay, so now, let's take the wings. They are hot, okay? But we want to coat them. Come in close. Come in close, because you have to see this. Oh, you must see this part. You coat them in that beautiful lemon pepper sauce. Ooh, and then we set them onto a platter, but this is not gonna be the serving platter that we're gonna use. Come down. Take a look. Ooh, wait, take a look. Girl, listen here. If you don't make this for your family, I know one thing. I'm not even gonna say it. Let's do this. Listen here, everybody. If you all enjoyed this video, make sure to give me a thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed, make sure you subscribe. Tell your family and friends and everyone you know. Tell the whole world about Gina Young, what I'm doing in this kitchen on a daily basis. When I come back, everything will be presented on a beautiful platter. I'm gonna say a prayer. You all get that first bite. Look at these. Come in, look at them. Oh, ooh, look at this one. Look at that. Ooh, you want that one. Take a look at it, everybody. Gina Young style lemon pepper wings. Make you some. Look at that. Oh my goodness. Heavenly Father, we want to thank you once again for this beautiful meal today. Lord, we thank you for your love time, your mercy, and your understanding. In Jesus Christ's name we pray. Amen. Amen once again to my beautiful prayer. I know you want a bite. And I'm going to give you a big old bite. Take the whole wing if you want. Look at that. You all asked for this recipe. I'm giving it to you. Look at that. I'm going to spoil you guys. Take a bite. Let me know how you like the recipe. And as always, God bless you all. Thank you for watching. God bless.